Welcome to the last lesson of this premium course, in which I'm going to show you how to export the data from these two animated light that we had. There we go. Let me just take a look and get back to our morph camera here, which is our final camera. I'm just going to disable the mesh and the particles because we don't need them, and change the frame range to 415 to 715 here. There we go. And there you go. You can see the lights get animated about here, and we want to export them, which is cool. And let's go ahead and do that. I'm gonna go ahead to my render setting, go to your save, and make sure the compositing project file here is saved. Change to After Effects if it's not in After Effects, and turn on Include 3D Data. The next thing is to you need to make sure is to define your frame range exactly as your project file. I mean, if it was a normal render, you would define the frame range as your camera, which is, you can see, 415 to 715. And the project file will be exactly saved like this. But if you just trying to save the project file and don't need the renders, you can go ahead and click on the save project file. Otherwise, if you just go ahead and define the frame range and define the place to save it, and when you render it, let me show you here, a project file will be saved automatically. But in this case, we are just need the data from the lights. I'm just show you how to work with those. But normally we would have the renders and the project files together, and we didn't need to click this. But if we just want to use the project file in After Effects, you can just click on the save project files, and it will give you the 3D data from your render. So let's go ahead and make sure everything is right. There we go. I'm just make sure I have the right frame range here, from 415 to 715, and also in my output, 415, 715. Now we can go ahead and click on save, click on save project file, define where you want to save the file. Let's go to our AE files, and I have it saved here, but I'm gonna override it. So I'm gonna double click on this and click on yes. Now it might take a few moments before it finished the rendering, finish the exporting, but and it all depends on the scene and the timeline that you have. So it's finished, so I can get back to After Effects. Here we are inside After Effects, and I just have the simple background, the only thing that I have. I'm gonna double click and import that file that I just exported it from Cinema 4D. I'm gonna double click on this, and if you open it up, you can see it has this composition, and it has all of the paths in it. If I open the composition, you can see all of the paths here. Now, if we were actually rendered the file, we would get the exact same thing, but instead of these empty files, we would get real files. But we just save the project file without rendering, so we get these empty files that are just names. So I'm going to delete them, and I'm going to delete these guys. It has been entered at 30 frame per second, so I'm going to my project setting and make sure it is 24. Okay, and also let's go ahead to frame 300. I'm gonna hit N to trim the comp here. So there we go, that's the data that we have. We have these three lights, which I don't need this, and this camera that I don't need, and this is the morph camera that we have. Look at this. Let's just go ahead and quickly create the background using Element 3D as we did. So I'm going to create a new solid here and name it background or whatever you like. And let's go ahead and apply the Element 3D, turn off the caps lock, and go to your render setting environment. Import your environment here, turn it off, go to the background again, and here you have the background. Okay, cool stuff. Let's just rotate it a bit until we get some nice stuff. There we go, that's not too bad. And the next thing is to how to use those two lights. If I hit U, you can see these lights have these animations here, which let me show you. You can see the intensity, color, and shadow darkness is really some sort of dummy data. They are having no sort of animation, so I can go ahead and simply delete these guys. There we go. And also this beginning and end keyframes, there are also nothing, and just we have this. Look at this, and look at the camera actually moving and coming. Look at this. Okay, now the only thing that we need to do is to make sure the animation of this light will continue throughout the timeline, and it's a matter of just copy and paste. So let me go ahead, I'm gonna copy these keyframes, Control and C, go ahead and zoom a bit more, and let's go to the last keyframe, page down, Control and V, let's go there to the last keyframe, page down, one keyframe forward, Control and V, and let's see, there we go, we have these lights this way. And I'm gonna go ahead and do the same thing for the other light that we have. So let's go ahead and just go to the last frame, page down, Control V, last frame, page down, Control V. Now we have this lights you can see animating throughout the timeline, which is cool. And let's see, and look at this, lights are moving around. Let's go to here, as you can see how they continue their animation here. So that's cool. The next thing I'm going to do is to create a new solid for the trap code particular effect. So let's go ahead and do that quickly. I'm gonna create a new solid and name it particular. And let's go ahead and apply particular. Now, particular is not a native After Effects plugin, and you have to go ahead and buy it from Red Giant website. I'm gonna double click on this. And we now have our particles in our scene. So let's go and change some stuff here. The first thing, I'm going to change my emitters to be emit from the lights. And the next thing, we need to change the light name to emitters, because that's what Trapcoat accepts. Let's go to emitter one, even though we can change that, but in this case we're just going to stay with what we have. So another emitter, and that's actually change this to emitter 2. And now let me go to the trap code point lights, and now we should be able to see some particles. Let's see, and we don't see any particles because we're using the lights, and the light intensity actually sort of controls the particle per second. So I'm going to double click on the light and make sure the intensity is something like 100, and also 100 for the other light. Now you can see the particles in the scene here, which is cool. I'm going to my particle effect, and the particles are, you know, from the 0 point they start to emitting particles, but I want to make sure the particles are going to be emitted where the camera, let's see, kind of hard to see what's going on with all the particles around. So maybe about here, you, when the lights actually come into play, maybe about, maybe about here. So I'm going to make sure it is 0 in this frame, create a keyframe, page down, and I'm gonna go start with something like 800 particles per frame per second. So now if you come down here and turn the layer back on, we have no particles, and from this frame they start generating particles, which is cool. I'm just going to my and rotate it so it's a bit more darker, the background, so we can see the particles a bit better. So now I'm gonna go to the trap code particular. I'm gonna change some stuff for this velocity, random velocity motion, the emitter size, everything is going to be zero. That's the first part. I'm gonna go to my particle colors and select a nice orange or blue color. That's absolutely up to you. Let me go ahead and let's see if I can find a nice blue color, which is, as I said, let's go to this cyan color here. I'm gonna go to my particle size and reduce them to something like 2. Go to the life seconds, at the moment it's 3, let's go to 2 and see what we're gonna get. Okay, and I'm going to the size of our life and use this curve. There we go, very nice. And that's what we have at the moment. If I just go ahead and quickly hit play, let's see what we're gonna get. And what we can do is to really make sure we just have this part. Let's see, that's where the particles start generating particles. So let's go ahead maybe to about here, hit B here, and let's hit 0. And now that's the animation that we have for the moment. Very simple and nice. Okay, and the next thing, I'm going to create a duplicate from this layer and change some of the settings. Velocity, I'm gonna go to something like 8, velocity for motion something like 5 maybe. And the next thing we're going to need to do is to, let's see, I'm gonna reduce the, maybe increase the lifetime of the particles to something like 5, or let's go to 4. And I'm gonna change the opacity of our life. We can change this thing, come down to physics, air, and I'm gonna use the wind y to make sure the particles are gonna have the tendency to go up when they emitted. And then under turbulence fields, I'm going to increase the effect position so we have a bit more irregularity in our particles. There we go. And that's what we have for the moment. I'm gonna go ahead and change the life per second to lifetime of the particle, something like 3. And I guess we can go ahead and I think that's gonna be enough. So this is what we have for the moment. So just see what we're gonna get. Let's go to a frame like this. This is the effect that we have. I'm just going to the second particle, and under the shading tab, let's go ahead and turn on the shadow here, and that will really help to make the effect look much more nicer. Let me just go ahead and have a, there we go, that's nice. And then finally, I'm going to add a simple glow effect. So let's go ahead and add some glow. Let's see what we have here. This is the glow. So let's go ahead and add it to our first layer. I'm going to maybe increase the threshold a bit. I'm going to the glow radius and increase it insanely, and also the intensity of it. There we go. And I'm going to control the same effects to my second particle layers. And let's go to this layer and see what we can do with it. And I'm just going to reduce, so make sure the colors are quite close. And I think this is quite nice. And I am thinking of, let's see what we can to make these guys a bit nicer. I'm going to the second layer and change the particle size to maybe 1.5 there. And I'm also going to select this layer, hit U, get back to the last frame, and increase the emitter to, let's go to 2500 for these guys. And this is what you're gonna have here. And also for the velocity from motion, I don't know, we can, I guess, make it a bit more, not that high, but let's go to like 20 maybe. And this is nice. And some random velocity wouldn't hurt too much. Let's go reduce this here. And the, okay, this is generally speaking not too bad. Let's see what we are having. I'm gonna get back and quickly hit zero there, just to see how the particles are actually working. It should be much more faster, generally speaking, but I'm having really tons of software running on my computer at the moment, so. Okay, it is nice, and it's really close to what we had in our original motion graphic, and just we missed the render, and if we had the render, everything would look exactly the same. Okay, it's quite nice and really feels natural. Let's see, this is what we have here. That's nice. Quite cool stuff here. Okay, now we can go ahead and go to the composition setting and make sure instead of 300, let's say 500 frame, and let's see. Now I'm going to make sure the lights and the camera are gonna exist for all the timeline. Also these two layers. Okay. I only need to go ahead and make sure the animation of the lights are going to be throughout the timeline. So I'm going to Control C, get back to the last frame, page down, and Control V. And there we go. Page down, Control V. And the same thing for this layer, Control C, get back to the last frame, page down, Control V. Did we copy that? Control C, and one more time, page down, Control V, and page down, Control V. So now the animation will continue much more. So let's go ahead and enjoy it one more time. So I'm gonna hit zero again, just before doing anything. Let's get back to, so I'm gonna Control Shift H to get rid of the overlays there, and let's see, hit zero again, and we're gonna see what we have here. Some nice stuff is happening here, as you can see, using the powerful chocolate particular. And let's see, let's wait a few seconds. I'm gonna go ahead and actually, just to make the whole thing a bit nicer, use optical flare and add it to the combination, and make the lights travel through as the path take place. We have a light at these parts and travel with the particles, and I think it would make the whole thing a bit nicer. And as you can see, we have this very nice effect here. Quite amazing, quite nice. And let's see. So let's hit zero. So that's what we have at the moment. Very nice. Very nice and exciting. And let's do the final process here. Okay. And it is going to be, let's go create a new solid, and I'm gonna name it Optical Flare. Optical Flare is a plugin by Video Copilot, if you didn't know. So I'm gonna go ahead and add the optical flares, and it creates some really nice flares to your scene. And I'm gonna go ahead and apply it to the light, change the positioning mode to track lights. As you can see, now we have two lights in our scene that they are going to be traveling with the existing lights. I'm going to change the rendering mode to be on transparent, and also make the whole layer to be screened there. And then I'm going to my options, and let's go see if there is a maybe preset we can use just to make life a bit easier. Couldn't find that much here. Let's see if there is anything in this folder. I don't know, maybe this is not too bad. I'm just going to get out some of this extra thing, maybe, and then I can hit. I'm just going to reduce the light brightness to something like 40 maybe, and we can go ahead and change the color if you want, maybe to, I don't know, orange. And there we go. If you like it, or if you want, you can go to the same blue color of your lights, which I guess it's kind of make more sense. So, which is, let's see, there we go. Now you have your lights. I'm going to something like 20, really just a small touch here, and there we go, you have this nice situation here. And we can go ahead and quickly around preview our scene to see what we have. Okay, there we go, here is our RAM preview, and as you can see, we have very nice motions and nice animation with just two simple lights that we imported from Cinema 4D inside After Effects. We could create this really nice motion, as you can see, very completely matching with the camera. And I hope you really enjoyed this series of tutorial from MoGraphPlus.com. We have other premium courses in our website, and we are adding more and more every week and every month. So make sure to check out MoGraphPlus.com to our other, and check out our other premium courses at MoGraphPlus.com. I hope you enjoyed this premium series. We covered a lot of techniques, especially deep fluid simulation and some advanced lighting techniques inside Cinema 4D. And we covered a lot of good techniques in After Effects, compositing wise. And hopefully we see you in our next premium courses.